Welcome to the first annual BBR Short Film Festival. I'm Thomas J. Beleza.
I'm Jaden McGibney.
And film is an expression of narration designed to pull its audience through an emotional truth, a truth that comes to life from more than the performers on screen or the writer who pen a script. Film, unlike most artistic ventures, is given life by a team of people, a group of people hoping for the greatest version of themselves to be present in the overall final product of storytelling.
A full-length feature is 90 minutes or more of all departments working together under the leadership of its director at the cost of a producer giving them the green light. This is the same for a short film. The phrase short film to us is not a lesser word from a feature. Both are built through the same labor of love. Budgets aside, the film industry is a place for all people to create together. And when you find your team,
you get films like the 9 chosen for our first annual BBR Short Film Festival. Films that give us a chance to see what amazing talent is out there working as a team, working to give life to a collective purpose. Finding the right team is an award unto itself. These accolades are our way of showing the appreciation for all their hard work, their passion, love, and the ability to express it all in their final product.
That's very poetic.
Yeah, I try. Yeah, that's what I do.
There are 10 categories to award individuals tonight. How we came to these winners was a group effort with judges. These judges work in several areas of the entertainment industry, truly honoring us with their time and effort to give us a chance to award the winners of tonight's ceremony. They eagerly watched the films multiple times, taking their time to give their full attention to the team of filmmakers.
Yeah, that's true. And we're grateful for it. In fact, thank you to all the presenters tonight who have decided to jump on and give this award show a little bit more than me and J.D. McGibney, you know, going back and forth throughout the night announcing winners. It would get very boring. So thank you to everyone. And a massive thank you to the audience watching these films for the month of October. Remember, you still have all of tomorrow to watch each film to help that film's team win the grand prize.
That's pretty grand.
Yeah, it is pretty grand.
The winners tonight will not determine the winner of the grand prize. That exciting grand prize is a development deal with BBR Productions. This deal will give us a chance to work with a team to develop either a feature film or a television series. What? I know, crazy.
Jesus, whoa.
What's exciting about that is we will then get the project pitch ready to shop around. Thomas J. Beleza and me. I are beyond excited to see what team wins the ultimate exciting prize.
Yes. Please follow us tonight as we begin our first annual BBR Short Film Festival of 2020. Now, presenting for Best Sound is an actor and a producer. You may have noticed him performing in Blindspot or not, a film currently in the first annual BBR Short Film Festival. If you're a fan of wrestling, you can hear his loud, booming voice on the A Shot of Wrestling podcast. He may mostly play villains in all his projects, but you can say for sure that he's the Schwan and only one to do it. Welcome, Mark Schwan, everyone.
Well, Thomas, if you're going to bring wrestling into it, you might as well introduce me right. Ladies and gentlemen, I am your favorite actor, the Hollywood assassin himself, Mark Schwan, bringing to you Best Sound. A visually stunning film will lose an audience if their sound isn't up to quality. Having a great sound team to capture the environment of each scene can be the life or death of an amazing story. Foley taking post-production to the next level can add realism to a scene otherwise better off set for the silent film era. These 3 short films gave us an example of quality work from a quality team. These are the nominees for Best Sound.
Oh, I have to thank you for that lovely breakfast. What'd you put in those potatoes? Spices?
Rosemary.
Rosemary?
Yeah.
Genius. Did you put it directly on the potatoes?
Yeah, it's not that unusual.
Have you ever thought of being a TV chef? I know people.
Oh, yeah, I think about it all the time.
I'm gonna call Gordon Ramsay. You're a shoo-in.
Please don't. Okay, that Stephanie, just stay out of sight, please.
I hope you're happy. You broke a sweet girl's heart. How could you do this? I don't even want to look at you. Don't.
And the award for best sound goes to Lars Deutsch for The Passenger.
Hello, my name is Lars Deutsch. I am very honored to win the best sound category at the BBR Film Festival. I want to thank the jury. I want to thank the director Alexander and the producer Tizia. I also want to thank the people outside of this bathroom that have been so patient while I did like 12 or 15 takes of this. And there is a scene in the bathroom in this film, so what I'm doing here totally has nothing to do with me being lazy or winging it. Thank you very much.
Congratulations, Lars, and a wonderful video. Our next presenter is no stranger to how important music is to the soul. An amazing artist in her own right through capturing moments in time through photography and her fantastic documentary about sound on the heavier side of music titled Atlanta Metal. We're delighted to bring you the editor and chief writer for the Midnight Children's Music Blog for the next award. Please welcome Emily Harris.
I'd like to thank BBR Productions for asking me to be a part of this short film fest as a judge. Now let's get into the award for best score. Music drives an emotional reaction through the body's spirit to pull the audience into an experience. A violin radiating in the background on one note, building tension. Two notes causing beaches to empty in the summer of 75. The raging adventure of battle, pulling two massive armies into one another. A score, when written with purpose, will invoke the body to lean forward or fall back into their chair. These are the nominees for best score.
What's wrong, William?
I'm fine. It's just, hey, when people call me William, let me fix you a drink.
Yeah, Jack, that's your number being called. Think you can handle it?
You're trying to piss me off, Harris?
Seems to be working.
After he goes down, you're going down.
Yeah, I'd like to see you try.
Hey, y'all, let me know when you're done playing footsie over the comm.
Watch your ass, Fisher!
And the award for best score goes to, drumroll.
It's Sun.
Barry J. Neely for Element.
Excellent. Wow. Hi, guys. Thank you so much for this. This was awesome. Joke's on you. Oh, you can't see me with this laser in my face. Anyways, this has been great. I was so thankful for BBR for having this in the film festival. This score was a lot of fun. Sonos Quartet, I had a string trio quartet in my living room to do this. Had a couple other key players, drummer. It was a lot to cram into an action movie, especially such a short action movie, but I wanted that score really to cut through. So guys, thank you so much. I was glad people could see this again, hear this again. I had so much fun creating the score, and I hope you guys had fun listening to it too. So thank you again, BBR.
Look, what can I say about our next presenter? She's a true blue New Yorker born and raised on Staten Island, an actress that brings our soul and her soul into every performance as we watch her. I first met her working on a music video shoot where she played a female lead in a vampire conceptual album. Very exciting. I had the privilege of directing her and filming her performance as she captured her truth on film. I present to you my friend, Alana the Chili.
Thank you so much, Thomas. And I'm so happy to be a part of this evening and to have been a judge for this festival. The grueling process of seeing hundreds, in some cases, thousands of performers to get the right person for the right part, then pairing them with your lead performers to see how great their chemistry truly is on screen. All this before a director or a producer gives their final say on who gets cast and who doesn't. This process takes stamina to get those hundreds down to one. These are the nominees for Best Casting.
You know, it's strange. You seem to be coping remarkably. I don't know how you do it.
What can I say? When you're moments away from meeting your maker, you tend to put things into perspective. I wouldn't expect you to understand.
We having problems.
Nothing to write home about.
Just usual fallings out.
I'm sure you have some war stories of your own, detective. Guilt follows us like a shadow.
That's weird. It's
weird.
It's weird. I know. It's weird. Has this ever happened to you? It's totally weird. I told you it was weird.
Yes, I'm glad we all agree
could
it's weird.
Go up and out through the roof and through the neighbor's building.
That's right.
Wait. Is that going to work?
Do
I have all this? I have all this shit back.
Yeah, I've been there before.
We got three of us. Over.
What are you going to do?
Not me. You. Take you.
Oh, sorry.
Oh! Shush! You're gonna wake up your roommate!
Who the hell are you?
Your wife!
What? No.
We got married!
How? Why?
What? Is this what it's gonna be like to be married to you? God, this is getting old.
You must have taken advantage of me while I was drunk.
We were both drunk and then got married, even though we're basically strangers. But look, let's just see where it goes.
And the winner for Best Casting goes to Alexander Bruckner for The Passenger.
Alexander Bruckner is not here at the moment, but we have Andrew accepting the award for it.
I'm accepting the award for casting? God, I had nothing to do with that except for getting cast. Can everyone hear me?
Yeah. Yes.
Cool. Yep, geez. I mean, this is thrilling. I mean, this project specifically, it's weird to be talking about something for best casting, but I guess it was important here because the dynamic between me and my co-star Ben is kind of the whole movie. So thanks. Is that good? Is that all right?
Wonderful.
Perfect.
And thank you very much for participating in the festival.
Yeah.
Alrighty. As a producer and a performer herself, this next presenter knows what it takes to get a film to come together. The process of each stage of production down to the release itself. From handling the creation to release of her film In the Moon's Shadow to being the founder of 3 theater companies in New York City. Here to present the next award, the life of the party, the wonderful Alyssa Pizzell.
Thank you so much, JD. Thank you, Thomas, for having me be a judge of this amazing first time 2020 virtual BBR Film Festival. So today, there's a saying that a film is only half finished once it's in the can. A director tells their story first, capturing moments in forever to tell their story best. A performer can bring to the table choices, dozens of choices, but which choice makes the final cut comes down to a solid eye for cutting scenes together flawlessly to keep an audience watching every moment, every word. These are the nominees for Best Editor.
Count 2 shots left.
You're doing that face again. What's wrong?
Everything's perfect.
To the door. We'll start this out some other day.
Fine. I can take a hint.
I beg to differ. This has taken a long time. Come on.
Yeah, someone's being cranky.
My actual love is on her way over. I need you out of here.
Will she bring me breakfast? Because I'm starving.
You know what? There are granola bars in the cupboard. You can grab one.
See,
hurry up, hurry up.
You're getting down with this whole husband thing?
Please don't. Crap! Okay, that Stephanie, just stay out of sight.
And don't beat your meat while I'm gone.
Fuck you.
And the winner goes to Leah Vrelibova for The Passenger.
Hey, sorry, I couldn't hear you there. Yeah. Cool that we won editing. This one I truly had nothing to do with. So, I mean, I guess I gave the editor a few looks so he had something to work with in the room. I don't know. That's amazing. The other films look really good too. So I don't know. We're doing well, I guess. Thanks, guys.
No problem. Thanks, Andrew. Hey, stick around. You never know. We might need you to be thankful for all the other projects as well. You know, I met our next presenter in the 70s, believe it or not. Okay, maybe we were just on the film, a film set doing a film for Steven Spielberg and maybe a Tom Hanks. But our outfit said 71 from head to toe. From there, I asked her to do multiple table reads for a television series we were working on, The Circle. I was instantly in love with her passion, truth, and friendship. She brings to life every word from her soul to our ears. I'm grateful to introduce Mary Ellen Molfetta.
Thomas, it was a trip traveling back in time with you. And thank you for allowing me to be here to recognize all of these talented filmmakers. Even before talkies gave us The Jazz Singer in 1927, moving pictures projected on the screens of Paris, France in 1895. This single event changed our world. Filmmaking has since become a $35.3 billion industry. Capturing a shot in a small box to breathe emotional truths on a massive 90 by 30 foot screen is no small task. The slightest move is a big gesture on camera. These are the nominees for Best Cinematographer.
Two shots are fired. She was dead after the first.
And the husband?
A scratch on him. He woke up after he had the shots. Then we found this.
Give me everything we have in the Langdale murders. This has gone on long enough.
Nasty sucker, out for civilian blood.
Might be our bot named Element. That lead and Jack's our ground operatives.
Oh, hell yeah. But I ain't got eyes on them either.
Fisher, we're in the red Ford Focus.
All right.
It's got four wheels and it moves, all we need. Paris, I think it's taking the form of that white truck.
Affirmative, Jack.
And the award for Best Cinematographer goes to Jake Bentley for The Man Who Sold the World.
Hi guys, thank you so much for choosing The Man Who Sold the World for Best Cinematography. As a cinematographer behind the film, I'm very thankful that you picked The Man Who Sold the World. It was a lot of fun making the film and it was a lot of fun working with the noir style to create such a unique short film. So thank you BBR yet again for putting on such a great festival and thank you for choosing our film as the winner.
An actor that could be seen in the Emmy-nominated web series Tough Love and HBO's High Maintenance, he wrote, directed, and co-produced the award-winning short film Corey, now streaming on Amazon Prime. In 2021, he is slated to star in the feature film The Pill and in a supporting role in the feature film Serial Killer in Harlem. Introducing Mr. Stephen St. Pierre.
Thank you, JD. Thank you, Thomas, for having me. And I hope everyone is out there safe. If music be the food of love, play on. Give me excess of it that, surfeiting, the appetite may sicken and so die. Words give meaning where actions on a page cannot. William Shakespeare gave us over 1,700 words of his making, each one designed to explore a need for purpose, a gift from him to us. What is a story without its composer of words, of thoughts, ideas? These are the nominees for Best Writer.
Getting married to a stranger, weirdly, not the worst thing I've ever done. But look, you also can't freak out about things you don't have control over. Serenity prayer.
Okay, well, we need to go to the courthouse and get this annulled or get a refund or whatever.
Oh, you don't even want to give this a chance? Thanks.
Not right now.
Hey, Evan. Yeah, I get it. Not right now, but I closed the restaurant last night and I have to be back in a couple hours. So if you could just keep it down so I can sleep.
Yeah, I'm kind of in a mess of a situation right now.
Oh, is this the wife that you were telling me about last night? Hi, I'm Ben.
Kylie, so nice to meet you. I'm sure we'll be seeing a lot more of each other.
Hey,
We have what you call a codependent relationship. You know, it wouldn't be so bad if you just showed me a little respect.
Respect? Are you fucking serious, dude? Tell me, princess. What should I respect you for? Is it your shitty job? The fact you let people walk all over you? Or that you're 33 years old and you're still waiting for your life to begin? I realize, Raymond, he waited patiently for his life, and then life passed him by.
Yeah, okay. Maybe I'm not the aggressive go-getter type, but if I listen to you, I'd probably be dead by now.
Congrats to all the nominees. And the award for Best Writer goes to Tab Murphy for The Passenger.
Hi, this is Tab Murphy, screenwriter of the short film The Passenger. A little surprised by this award. I'd like to thank BBR Productions for recognizing our little film. And I'd also like to thank Alexander Bruckner, the director, and the entire cast and crew. I had a blast writing it. I know they had a blast making it. And it's always nice that your efforts get recognized in this way. So thank you very much.
You never know who you will meet in life. Be nice to everyone because you never know who someone is or who they know. But how can I not be nice to this next presenter that I met while interning over at Tuff Gong Worldwide? Every day was a learning experience filled with laughter. Who knew that Ziggy Marley's record label was going to introduce me to a lifelong friend who is both a comedian, musician, and a writer? Wait a second, that's three things. Anyway, here is Robert Rico.
How goes it, everybody? Nice to be here. As you can tell, me and JD are lifelong friends. I was told this was a costume party. I'm sure you think I'm kidding, but I take these things very seriously. Now, on to more serious things. The greatest performances can come from less than 15 minutes of screen time. Hannibal Lecter, portrayed by Anthony Hopkins, gave value to that sentiment from Konstantin Stanislavski's remarks that there are no small parts, just small actors. Now, you want to be the lead, then listen to Dab Greer's statement. Every character actor in their own little sphere is the lead. Be more than your line count. Now, these are the nominees for Best Supporting Performer.
Hey man, yeah, I get it. You may have just lost the love of your life and you want to chase after her, but you also want to respect her autonomy. Yeah, but I would love to go to sleep. So if you could just shut the fuck up. Thank you.
C-U-M. The Langdale Killer.
I mean, I'm flattered, but I think a simple phone call would have yielded similar results, wouldn't you say?
I know it looks bad, mister. He gets in these moods. But it don't really mean nothing.
Does this symbol mean anything to you, Travis?
If you have come to me looking for another head to mount on your wall, I'm afraid you are mistaken, Detective. I am not the Langdale Killer.
All right, those are all amazing candidates. Let's get the envelope. Thank you. All right. So you guys put a lot of budget into this year. So the award for best supporting performer goes to the robot for Element. The robot. Wait, no. That seems like this is written in a robot's handwriting. This was in fact written by a robot's handwriting, and that robot's extremely lucky it's just a puppet, otherwise security would kick its ass out. But it looks like the actual award goes to, for Best Supporting Actor, Gail Gillis for The Passenger. Give it up.
Oh my gosh. Hi, everybody. I'm sorry, I'm really, really surprised. I want to thank the festival, of course. I want to really thank, I'm sorry, I'm really shocked, the director and all the team who believed in me while I was just moving in LA by myself, knowing nobody and being very lonely and lost. So thank you. Thanks a lot.
That was beautiful. I love when they end it. That's why we do this, for that to happen, just what just happened. So apparently I met this kid at a guitar center. From there, we basically spent 10 years playing music in a band together, and I learned a lot from him. I learned that you can never trust a bear in a wrestling match. They don't know the rules. Second, a best friend is more than someone you just know. He's the person you can call brother, and no matter how much silence there is between you, you always know what's being said. Welcome to the screen, my best friend, and hopefully yours, Mr. Justin Hunt.
Thank you very much, Thomas. Life would be way less fun without you in it, so thank you. Sanford Meisner's teachings define the art. Quote, acting is behaving truthfully under imaginary circumstances. Thousands of students have benefited from his technique since his passing in 1997. Marlon Brando's presentation in A Streetcar Named Desire elevated on-screen behavior to challenge the craft to be more than reciting words, provoking a change in the craft. These are the nominees for Best Lead Performer.
The best part about a relationship is getting to know the other person, and I think this is the best way to start a marriage. And like, who says that our drunk brains aren't smarter than our sober brains just because we had 3 shots of Hennessy? I know I can think clearly. I don't know. Marriages are ticking time bombs anyway, you know? Somebody leaves, somebody forgets to pick the kids up from school, somebody poops with the door open, or somebody just dies. It's all a dead end.
Come back. Come back. Come back.
That is a hell of a question. You called me, remember?
This old thing, bro.
Whenever you get in trouble, need a little backbone, you call me. And I get to come out and play.
And the award for Best Lead Performer goes to Andrew Garrett for The Passenger.
Wow. Hey, thank you guys so much, BBR. It's a surprise. Congrats, Gail, by the way. You're still watching. Couldn't have done it without her. Ben and Randy Hernandez, our 4th co-star. Thanks to Alexander Bruckner, the director. Grant McAllister, the cinematographer. Amazingly talented guy. I was just lucky to get this part. It was such a special production, and thank you guys for recognizing that. Tab Murphy, who won earlier and wrote an amazing script, and I'm really grateful. Oh, Stephen King. How do I forget him? I'm sure he's watching, so it's best I say his name. Thank you guys. Thank you so much. I really, really. Marlon Brando. I know he was mentioned earlier. Stella Adler. John Jack Rogers. I'm kidding. Okay. Thank you so much. It means the world. I appreciate it. So amazing that our film was recognized.
Thank you, Andrew. I love you, man. Look, personally, I've never been more excited in my life to introduce this next presenter. Put a guitar in his hands, throw him on stage, and see him become an exciting performer in his own right. There's an excitement to knowing someone as well as I know this guy. By the way, he may be 5'2", but fills a room with love, compassion, and friendship, which honestly adds excitement to any experience. Someone who is excited to use the word excited, I'm excited to introduce J.D. McGimdy, everyone.
Thank you, Thomas. And how exciting was that? So thank you again, Thomas, for reminding me why I tolerate your very, very loud personality while I'm trying to drink my coffee in the morning just to get through the day of dealing with your many, many, many puns. One might even say that it's punishment. Oh, captain, my captain, our fearful trip is done. The ship was weathered every wreck. The prize we sought is won. The port is near, the bells I hear, the people all exulting. Lead us into the dark unknown with a plan and team at your side. An amazing team is nothing without a leader, nor a leader any good without a team. I have a vision, and that vision must come to life. These are the nominees for Best Director.
Doing that face again. What's wrong?
I got an offer.
How long?
10 months. I want you to come with me.
We have had our feet on the ground for all of 5 seconds. Do you really think now is the time for something like that? We can't just uproot.
Well, if we want to see each other, I'm not sure what other options are.
Leaving? You're talking about leaving? You wouldn't do that?
Well, watch me. I'm tired of carrying your ass, doing your dirty work. You need to show me something, pal. We're through.
I gotta ask. How'd someone like you end up with a band of misfits like us?
Started back in the day when I played touch football with the boys at recess.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Goes back that far.
Mm-hmm.
Touch footy.
Love the strategy of the game. Figuring out the play, how to get past the other team's defense. And not to brag or anything, but we dominated the playground.
Bet you did.
Yeah, we did.
And the award for Best Director goes to Alexander Bruckner for the passenger.
Hey guys, I feel honored to be receiving this award today. I want to thank everybody at BBR Productions. Thank you, Tom. Thank you, JD. I want to thank my producer. I want to thank my scriptwriter and obviously my entire cast and crew. You guys did a wonderful job. This would not be possible without you guys. And I also want to thank my family and my girlfriend. I'm sending you hugs and love from sunny Austria. Take care, guys, and stay healthy.
Someone not who you think wrote this introduction for himself. So I'm going to ad-lib a little bit to give my own thoughts on him by reading the rest of what he wrote for me to say.
Sorry.
He beats the odds whenever they're presented. He's the guy who knows somebody that knows somebody, who, at one time or another, knew my uncle's best friend's former lover's roommate, which basically means that he and I are not related, no matter how much we look alike. A mission to help so many in life find their yes in bringing reality to their dreams. My friend and yours, the one and only, thank God, Thomas J. Beleza.
Hey, oh, thank you, JD. I really appreciate that well-written intro. Look, much goes into making a film. The awards given tonight are a testament to the small fraction of those involved in its process. Trust me. Even I'm a little disappointed we didn't see who the best grip award went to. Really, I mean, and what does a gaffer even do? Besides the point, I would like to say whatever it is, it has to be important to the final product of what takes more than a few weeks to film. Pre, principal, and post-production is a process. These are the nominees for Best Short Film.
You are not helping Jillian.
Jillian? Jillian Pappas?
Yeah.
St. Mary's Class of 05?
Yeah.
Kylie Miller!
Hey, girl!
Small world!
Oh, my God. What the heck are you doing here?
Right now I'm doing this.
Oh, my gosh. Such a clusterfuck, right?
I know.
Oh, my God. Speaking of Fox, I totally didn't find your boyfriend.
No, she wouldn't. Like, this dress is white as fuck.
Right? That's pretty white.
Yeah.
No,
it's all right. I mean, it's not your fault at all. Evan's the real asshole here.
Deep down inside, you always wanted to be like me. Well, here's your chance.
I can't. You know I can't.
Then grow a pair. You're just gonna let her die.
Stop it. I'm not like you.
That's for damn sure. But like I said, I'm tired of carrying you.
At the wrong end of a 45.
Two shots are fired.
She was dead after the first.
And the husband?
Not a scratch on him. He woke up after he had the shots. Then we found this.
Give me everything we have in the Langdale murders. This is coming.
All right. And for our first annual BBR Short Film Festival, the award for Best Short Film goes to the team behind The Passenger.
And I guess I'm the ambassador for The Passenger. God, thanks so much. I really feel strange talking for Alex and the real team behind it. I was just in it. The other films look amazing, guys. You should all be very proud. I mean, based on the clips I've seen anyway. Thank you guys, BBR Productions. Yeah, I guess I don't really have much else to say, but thanks. It means a lot that the film is getting attention. Because it's a lot of work went into it. A lot of talented people behind it.